Joining us now is Professor B.B. Bhattacharya. He's an economist. So it seems that the government is literally ramming through these proposals, and Sandeep Banza in fact called it like a state of emergency that they needed to do that, and now suddenly they've decided to bite the bullet. They're ramming these proposals through. Do you think this is the right way to go about it to try and end policy paralysis?
Well, ideally this should have been done in a phased manner, but then now that there is a acute criticism of the government stalling key policy decisions, so they seem to be now in a hurry to show that they actually are on the path to some of the reform measures. So manner in which it is done also looks a bit defensive, but nevertheless, some of these are desirable. After all, FDI in retail has been needed for quite some time. It was felt that aviation FDI is welcome, but why restricted only to private players? Why not Air India also have the benefit of the FDI capital?
Right.
After all, Air India has good planes. All they need is that management and cash.
Mm.
So some of them are mixed up of a bit of conservative populism, some bit of ad hocism. But on the move, on the whole, I think if the move goes on through all the process, then it will be a good thing.
Also, do you think that the government should be putting in enough safeguards to try and ensure that there is substantial ownership as well as control of Indian nationals in these industries? Because that is one of the biggest fears.
You see, the government in any case putting a cap on the FDI capital. But the more important thing is, are they going to bring in the fresh capital? Because many often you have seen the FDI actually promise, but they don't materialize. They don't bring in the capital, they try to take the management within share market of India and things like that. At the same time, equally concerned is Indian companies are not investing. They're having a lot of surplus cash recently, and they're taking it away simply because there is not enough investment opportunity within the country. The gross investment ratio has drastically fallen. So there is a concern that there is a coordinated need to encourage the investment in the country, whether domestic or foreign. Foreign part is only one. I wish the Indian part also, there is some action to encourage the Indian investment back in the India.
Thank you, Professor Bhattacharya, for joining us with your perspective on the story.